Jing and Joyello, we'll build it up and we're building it solid as Zarok. And Jing and Joyello, you're tuning in to the number one online TV. It goes without saying, Bamboo Bush TV. Thank you to you and yours for following, sharing, and spreading the word about the program. My name is Lalo Moon, and I am so excited to be your anchor of information, education, and entertainment. And I'm glad to see Teta, the climate change as well as the developmental drinks with Orion Fortune from Rainbow Warriors International. He is going to be finding out more and peeling up the strips to find out more about what he's currently doing. Get drinks, climate change. So let's check it out.
Moloni Mahlali, mandinamkele kwinkqubo yethu ekuthiwa yinkqubela esuka kwalavi langa audiovisual initiative. Namhlanje ndiniphathele uRyan Fortune osuka kwisebe le-developmental drinks. Ryan, mandikwamkele kwinkqubo yethu yakwalavi. Please introduce yourself and tell us why you're here.
Okay. So My name is Ryan Fortune. I'm one of the organizers of something called Development Drinks. It happens the second Wednesday of every month in Observatory Cape Town at a place called Touch of Madness, which is a restaurant. And it's basically a networking event, a social networking event for, and it's really aimed at people who are in the space of development. So it could be, you could be an academic, you could be an activist, could be someone who works for an NGO that is dealing with human development issues. But really the focus has been lately for the past 2 years mainly on people in the space of climate change and development, which are issues that really cross each other. So it's just a space for people to come and meet and network outside of the normal workspace. Yeah.
Tell us, are there any opportunities that arise within the space and within this network?
Yeah. So what happens in this network is that as it's a networking event, what happens is that I have a very good idea. I have a total idea of who's coming. I mean, actually, until people come, I don't know. But when people sign up to come to the event, they tell me what they're interested in, they give me their names, who they work for, and what areas they're interested in. And then I'm able to, by getting that information, I'm able to, when they arrive at the event, I'm able to matchmake them with certain people that I think have similar interests or could assist them in whatever they're doing. Many times we've had young students who come from the universities who are looking for jobs, and then you have people who are potential employers who also come to the event. And because I'm familiar with what people are looking for, I make introductions to people. And obviously because people are having a bit of a drink and it's in a social setting, it becomes much more easy to connect with people than in a job interview kind of situation, you know. And so I know that several people have found jobs as a result of coming to that event.
Wow. We've got a topical issue in South Africa and globally at large. It's just about the climate change and this renewable energy. And I've heard you through, as we were chatting, that you do connect people and companies within that. Can you tell us about those opportunities and that space?
Yeah. So the opportunities in climate change, I mean, I think we have to take a couple of steps backwards first. To understand that climate change is really, at this point, if you look at the science of it and the facts, it's what they call an existential crisis. It means that it's a problem that has now become a threat to the civilization that we have built over the last 200 years. The opportunities that arise out of that is that basically, they say always in the midst of crisis, there's always opportunity. You know,
yes.
So looking at this crisis, which is very scary, the option is to be very scared and say, well, there's nothing we can do, or the other option is to say, well, we're not finished yet. Let's tackle this thing, and this is how we do it, and then to find solutions, okay? So there are lots of people who have been looking for solutions. I mean, one of the issues and the real problem is that we are polluting the atmosphere. We're polluting the air with the petrol engines, the factories, all the pollution, the air pollution. It's making the planet warmer, and it's affecting the weather and the climate, which will affect the food supplies and the agriculture and the farming. And so when you see the food prices going up and you wonder why, it's because maybe some crops are not growing well enough. And so it connects to everything, yeah? Mm-hmm. So what are the opportunities within that place of crisis? So some people have looked for solutions. One of the solutions is to move from dirty fossil fuels to clean renewable energy for your homes and for energy. So it's solar panels, it's wind turbines, it's all the renewable energies. It's even water is an energy source. Yeah. I was reading the other day a story about this boy in India, for example, who has made this invention where he basically discovered how you can harness the wind that is made by cars passing on the highway. You know, so the cars are speeding on the highway, and he found a way you can put those fans there, and when the cars go past, it's spinning the thing and it's creating energy somehow, you know, because of the rotation of the thing. So it's become, so there are whole industries. There are whole industries that are existing that have developed looking at solutions for the problem of pollution. And then you have also new ideas that are available that people need to start thinking about, you know. So if you want to really get into the climate space and looking at the solutions for climate change, I think it really requires young people who think outside of the box. Mm-hmm. Who maybe study a bit of the science of climate change, who try to understand how energy works, who understand and actually look at finding small scale solutions to some of the problems that come as a result of climate change. So, for example, another kind of not necessarily solution but an intervention. If you think that because of climate change the food becomes more expensive. A really good solution is to find a way to start growing your own food, you know, in a small space, because it helps you to become more resilient to food price increases. Yeah, mm-hmm. One of the things they say is that if the food system collapses, it will take 3 days for all the supermarkets to run out of food. In 5 days, people will be beating each other in the street. And there's chaos, okay? So how to stop that from happening? How to prevent that from happening? Or how to be able to take care of yourself with food and the basics that you need is another intervention that you can look at, you know? So all of these little things that we think are not related to climate change, at the end of the day, it's really the survival of humanity that's really at stake, you know? And so it's to look at all the different avenues. I mean, I don't have all the answers, and even the government doesn't have all the answers. So it needs people to, it's up to citizens to really become really innovative and find the solutions, you know.
Do you think that South Africans in particular have positioned themselves in terms of overcoming or being the being part of the problem solving of this climate change?
Well, I think that one of the problems, I used to be a journalist for a long time, and I think one of the problems in South Africa is that the media, and I know this from my own experience, the media has never really taken the issue of climate change seriously. Mm-hmm. It's always been seen as an environmental issue, put on the environmental page, and even in that context, in the newspapers today, with internet and all the competition, the first beat that they cut is the arts, and it's environmental. You know, they will put on crime, and they will put on all the scandals and all the politics and stuff. But climate change is something that crosses everything. It's not just a little, you know, it's not just about the environment. It's actually about people's lives, it's about jobs, it's about the price of food, it's about even, you know, if you are in summer and people, you know, there's a heat wave, you know, if people are living in shacks, you are not able to, there's a limit at which your body can really take it, so it becomes a health issue as well, you know, and so people need to know what to do when it's, when it gets that hot. We've seen some of the extreme weather events, just even the last week, you know, the storms that are coming and getting worse. In places like the Eastern Cape, there's drought, you know. So all of these issues are problems, but that need solutions. And I think that I think the media hasn't done enough to make people aware. And I think it's worked in the favor of the companies, the fossil fuel companies, and also government, to keep people not aware, so that they don't start to put pressure on government to do something. You know, because once you see a problem, you have to do, you have to find a way to solve
it.
You know, instead of reacting to the problem, like what happened with the drought. You know, the government was warned 12 years before that they were going to run out of water. Yeah, and they didn't take it seriously. You know, they thought that there'll always be water. You know, the rain is always coming at the same time. Then when the rain stops coming for 3 years, then they react.
Then it hits. Well, if someone wants to know further about this climate change, about the drinks at large, where would they contact you?
Well, they should. I've got an organization. It's a non-profit organization called Rainbow Warriors International, and it's an NGO that's trying to connect people with some of these issues. And the best place to find us is on Facebook, and there's a Facebook group called Rainbow Warriors International. And I will be posting the date for the next development drinks. I will create it as an event on the group. And the next one will be on the second Wednesday of next month.
Okay, okay. Thank you very much. Bahlali apho ekhaya, iDependable Drinks, enza uthi ni network engayo, nidibane nabantu enifuna udibana nabo, noba kungomsebenzi, noba kungesikolo, noba kungebusiness. Now, to name contact on Facebook or Ryan Fortune. Thank you very much.
Yes, that was Mr. Fortune alongside Ubongi giving us Zongezo information that we need. So keep your eye on the ground so that you find out when it's happening next. And us, you can always follow us on Facebook. It's Bush TV. Or if you have any queries about our program, or you have any other information that you want us to share with the public, you can email us at bushtv@gmail.com. We're also on YouTube, so press like, share, and spread the word. My name is Lama Sipuma Gorezoro from Grahamstown, making the Eastern Cape proud. This is BM Music. Do enjoy. So long. Goodbye.